Hi, I'm Jamie from the Utah Education Network. Welcome to a new episode of UEN Nearpod News. In this episode, I'll show you how you can convert your Canva presentations to Nearpods. So your first step is to upgrade your Canva account to a Canva for Education account. This is free for all K-12 educators and is going to give you the full experience of Canva. But it's also going to allow you to download your presentations for use in Nearpod. So there are a few ways that you can use your Canva presentations in Nearpod. In this video, I'm going to show you my two favorite ways and the ways that I think most closely align with how you're already creating your Nearpods. So first up is downloading your Canva presentations as a PowerPoint and then uploading your slides to Nearpod. Let's see how this works. To get started, I will go to canva.com and select my presentation. I'm going to start from scratch just so you can see the entire process. So our first step would be to select a template and then build our presentation from there. Here's a little pro tip. In Nearpod presentations look best if they are a 4x3 presentation. By default, your PowerPoint and your Google presentations will be a 16x9. So you can go ahead in Canva and create from the templates that are 4x3, or we can just modify and resize a template to fit our specifications. And that's what I'm going to do first. So I'm going to select a template here. So I'll just click on this one that says Group Project. And on the left-hand side, it's going to open up and show me all of my additional pages. I'm just going to click on Apply All 10 Pages so you can see how this works. Next, to resize my presentation, in the top corner, I'll click on Resize, and I already have it built in for my 4x3 specifications. So here I have 1024 by 768 pixels, and that changes a 16x9 into a 4x3. So I'm just going to click on that box. You might have to enter those in up here, but I'm just going to click on the box and then say Copy and Resize. Now, Canva is going to shrink my presentation down to have those other dimensions. Now, let's say that I've gone through this presentation and I've made all of my edits and it's ready to go. So to move my Canva presentation into PowerPoint, I'll come up here in the top left-hand corner, I'll click on Share, and then I'm going to click here on More, scroll down about to the bottom and say Save as Microsoft PowerPoint, and then click Download. Once my presentation has downloaded, then I'm going to go into my Nearpod account. I'm going to create a new lesson, and from my Finder, I am going to drag and drop the PowerPoint presentation that I just downloaded from my Downloads menu right there into Nearpod. This is going to upload my PowerPoint slides just like it would have had you created this presentation in PowerPoint. So while that's uploading, you can see right here in the back, it says file is processing. I can be adding content. I can be adding activities to this slide, adding all of my Nearpod elements. And when the slide deck has uploaded, then I'll see that there in the background as well. And there it is. There is my Canva presentation in Nearpod. So next up is downloading your Canva presentation into Google so you can use the Google Slides add-on. Now, this requires a few more steps than the PowerPoint presentation did, but if you love using the Google Slides add-on like I do, then it's totally worth it. So let's take a look at how this one works. To use the Google add-on with Canva, You're going to start the same way that you did with creating your presentation first, making all of your edits here. And then again, we're going to click share in the top right-hand corner. But this time I'm going to click here on Google Drive. Now, the first time you do this, you'll need to connect your Google account, so it will ask you to log in. But after that, it's just going to first ask, where do you want to save this file to? I just want it right here in my account, so I'm just going to click here on Choose. And then I need to select my file type to be PowerPoint. Now, I know that's weird because we're going to use the Google add-on, but trust me on this. So we're going to save the presentation as a PowerPoint in our Google Drive. Next, I'm going to go into my Google Drive. And right here, I have my presentation. So I'm just going to double click on it to open it. And now it's going to convert it from a PowerPoint presentation and open it in Google Slides. But as you can see, it's still a PowerPoint presentation, so I don't have my extensions to use my Google add-on. So the next step would be to save as Google Slides. Now it's going to convert my PowerPoint presentation into a Google slide deck. And I can make any changes that I need to my content once it's in my Google Slides. So if there are any changes coming over from Canva into Google Slides, you can go ahead and make those now. Now we're going to open and use our Google Slides add-on. So I'll click here on Extensions and then Nearpod. And open Nearpod. If you do not have the Google Slides add-on, then you'll want to watch the video on my page that will help you add that Google Slides add-on. So we're going Extensions and then Nearpod and open Nearpod. And now we have all of our Nearpod elements over here on the right hand side, and we can just start adding those into our presentation. We're going to pretend here. And then we can save and go to Nearpod. So it was almost as if we created that Canva presentation right in Google. And now you see it's being uploaded into my Nearpod account. And then from here, I can launch my Nearpod lesson. So that's it for this episode of UEN Nearpod News. I hope that these tips and tricks will help you use your Canva presentations in Nearpod. And if you need additional support setting up your Canva for Education account, or maybe using the Google add-on, then make sure you check out my page at uen.org/Nearpod. Thanks!